Hey, you guys are watching Proof Weight Loss Surgery Works, and I'm your Friday vlogger, Leanna. So this week's topic is, how do you overcome challenges on your weight loss surgery journey? You know, once you have weight loss surgery, there are so many new things, new ways you have to learn things. I'd say the first year, maybe even 2 years, really is when you come, you know, face to face with all these new challenges, because you're changing your life, right? So, you know, exercise may be a challenge for you. Water may be a challenge for you. Protein may be a challenge for you. Sugar may be a challenge for you. And so I learned, you know, I really want this to be a lifestyle. I really want to find balance with things. So, you know, I did things where, I've always worked out my entire life. You know, I've worked out on and off, okay? So it was like I would go to the gym for 3 months and then I wouldn't go to the gym for 6 months, you know? So I constantly struggled with consistent fitness. So I got a personal trainer, and I got a personal trainer with a 1 year contract. So I had a personal trainer for about a year and a half, almost 2 years, first, you know, post-op surgery. And that helped with making fitness a lifestyle. So I feel like now fitness is a part of my life. Fitness is embedded in me, that, you know, no matter what, I will always have some kind of fitness going on in my life. So I'm not saying you have to go out there and get a personal trainer, but, you know, find something that will help you create a new habit. So, you know, like I said, I struggled with being consistent with fitness, and the opportunity came up of having a trainer, and I took it. It could be something where you get a workout partner, or, you know, you do some kind of fitness program that's, you know, for a couple months or something, and it helps you learn to be consistent with, you know, fitness. I had a lot of challenges with making food choices, like on the weekend. I struggled with weekend fat girl really bad. That was a really bad, big challenge for me. You know, my husband and I both are off Saturday, Sunday. So it was our day that we went out to eat. We, you know, did whatever, and I had a really big problem with weekend fat girl. So I fixed that by changing my weigh-in day. My original weigh-in day was Thursday. So I would weigh in Thursday. I would party like a rock star till, you know, through the weekend. And then come Monday, I would get back on track, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And so I was in this vicious cycle of losing and gaining. So what I decided to do was change my weigh-in day to Monday. And with that, I had to hold myself a lot more accountable on the weekends. So that was a challenge that I had faced. You know, you just learn, you know, to overcome things and learn, I guess, a way to get around it, you know, and kind of force yourself out of, you know, whatever that kind of challenge is, I guess. Or come up with a game plan. You know, if something is, if you're struggling with something, come up with a game plan and really, you know, work that plan. And you know, if I was struggling with water, so, you know, it's kind of, you've got to mentally, you know, force yourself, okay, before I eat this or do that, I have to have so much water, you know, ounces, you know, down. So, I mean, come up with, you know, ways of, or solutions to, you know, your problem or, you know, whatever you're struggling with. So, you know, yeah, so those are some things that I have struggled with. I struggled with weekend fat girl for quite a bit. I struggled with, you know, wanting to make sure my fitness was consistent, and now, you know, it is, it's a habit. You know, my current challenges are, you know, I'm struggling with some regain. I'm struggling with getting my mindset, you know, right. And, you know, I'm just not happy. And, you know, it's interesting because, you know, my husband this morning, he was like, what do you have to not be happy about? Like, you have an amazing life. And he was like, if anything, you should be angry at yourself for not getting your shit together, you know? And didn't really think about it that way until he said it. And it's like, I feel like a light bulb, you know, kind of went on and was like, you know, I should be angry with myself and, you know, let that drive, you know, the getting your crap together, you know? And so, I've just let stress get the best of me. And, you know, between work and remodeling my house. And so this is, you know, the current situation I'm struggling with, and I'm trying to come up with a game plan. So, you know, that's kind of, I guess, you know, when you're challenged with something, you know, meditate on it and kind of think like, okay, let's come up with a game plan. Let's, you know, how can we, you know, solve this issue? And, some people may need to put that in writing. Some people may need to talk it out loud with somebody. You know, kind of do whatever you got to do. And, you know, when you're challenged with something, reach out to somebody or, you know, something, and, or, you know, do some research on it or, you know, something, and kind of have that maybe help you along as well. But yeah, so that's what I got on this week's topic about challenges, and I will talk to you guys next week.